Welcome everyone back to Medieval Dynasty. This is episode 5. If you missed the previous episodes, go and check them out. So in that montage in the beginning, we finished both our barn and our hunting lodge here. So we're kind of getting the ball rolling. I also... did I do a lumber mill yet? I'm not sure if I did. I got my workshop here, but I really need a lumber mill. So let's see. Hit the wrong button there. What do we need? Oh, we don't even... oh, wait, no. Oh, we got our building limit exceeded. So, right now, I guess that's not something we can do. However... we can go into the knife making business. So we need some stones. Let me see. We're going to store our logs in here for the time being. And our sticks. Pretty much anything woodworking. We do have straw in here too. Let's take that out. And the feathers. Alright, we'll take the stone because we're going to need that for building. So if we craft some knives, I just took the sticks out that I needed. This will actually be one of the good ways of making money early game. Right now we can craft 3. There is a couple of things that I changed as well as far as server setting. Well, one thing, and that's the fast crafting. So basically one revolution will craft everything that we've set up. I think that's just, from a content creator standpoint, I think that's just going to make for a lot better enjoyment watching what we're doing here, instead of, you know, having to wait for each item to craft every time. Alright, let's put some of this food away here. I don't even know what that is. We do have a porridge, oat roll, flatbread, and we got some potions here. We'll keep the roasted meat for now. Resources, we're going to put the rest of this stuff in here for now. Although I think I'm going to grab the sticks back out of here. Just for when we come across some stone, we can sell. So, we did get some skills while we were building there. And we got 2 points to spend. We're going to put one more in here because it'll get us more points for each time we level up that. And let's see. One with the earth. Slower durability loss for pickaxe and shovels. 50% resources recovered from destroying structures. Let's do the force of nature for the second. No, we'll up that one to the max. That way we have more points for each time. Alright, 5 of 5 buildings. So we gotta level up that. And I believe we do that by doing some quests. I think it's also towards the end of the day right now. So we might want to sleep. And then start fresh on the next day. So let's do that. Next day. We can get out of the rain, maybe, too. So this is late summer, I believe. We did have our cabbage planted here, so that's going to help us out going forward. And let's head into town. We're going to try to collect some stone along the way. Oh, I forgot we had more logs up here. We've been doing our rolling them down the hill trick for this spot. I'm really liking the looks of this homestead here. It looks pretty sweet. We'll put our logs in here. The next building we need to get is the workshop, because that's really going to add to what we can do for as far as making money. We can make our stone knives for now. But our... ability to make money is really going to grow once we get that workshop going. Or I should say the, where we can go get, lumber and stuff like that. The woodshed, I believe, is what it's called, actually. Then we can start making vials, which are a really good way to make money. just from playing in my own time, watching videos. Got a lot of helpful tips for comments in the latest video there, so do appreciate those. Anybody wants to leave any more helpful tips, I will gladly take them. Alright, let's see. Can we make any more knives? Yes, we can. There's also other tricks. Ooh, I just leveled up in crafting. Let's take a look here. We got 2 points here. I think we're going to do the same thing. We're going to max that out for crafting. That's really going to benefit us the most right now. Let's head into town. We can sell some of these knives that we made. We'll be a knife salesman. While we're in town, we'll also see if we can talk to a few people, see if we can get this quest done. There was another rock. Oh, another couple rocks. There we go. More. We're just going to kind of collect rocks on our way so we can make more knives. There's another 4. I believe they sell for about 40 a piece, which is really good early game. Alright. Did I walk by the bridge? I think I did. Let's go back here. We're not too far away from towns. We got 2 towns right around us right now. But we're definitely far enough away that I think we're in a pretty decent spot. Plus, I like the looks of the spot there. Alright, we really got to make our way towards getting a bow. Which I believe now that we have the hunting shack. Let's see here. Hunting lodge. So we have our bow purchased and our stone arrows purchased. So we can really start making those. I think all we need is a linen thread, which we don't have the ability to make right now, but we can buy one. All right, we'll go talk to Edwin right here.
How can I help you? My wares never disappoint.
Selling our knives. We got 12 knives. That's going to be 240. Yeah. That's nice.
Best goods in the valley.
Let's see what else we have here. We need a linen thing. I don't think he's going to have it.
See you soon.
Once we have enough food, we can definitely get somebody here that will help gather resources for us, but...
How can I help? Best goods in the valley.
Let me see. Do you have anything? Pew. Nope.
Whatever you need, I've got it. Have a good day.
I think our best bet might be the guy up here with the cattle. Even he might not have it.
How are you? Best goods in the valley.
And he doesn't. We do have bucket, but we don't really need a bucket. We can make one of those.
Have a good day.
All right. Well, let's take a look here at our quest, because we really need to finish some of those. Complete some quests for neighbors in town. Unigos. We got to talk to Sambor. We can do that one. That would be one done. That was wait for next summer. Night hunt. Will expire this season, so we're probably going to fail that one, not going to lie. So we could talk to Sambar. That's really the only one we're going to be able to complete. We still have a decent amount of daytime left, but this is the last day of summer. So we'll go talk to them. We don't have the means to buy one of the lines for the bow, so... Maybe we can get one from him, because he is like a hunter out in the woods, so we'll see how that goes. Ooh, there is. I forgot I cut down all these trees here. So I did learn that if you leave the stumps as well, the trees will grow back after 2 years, I think it was said, so it's also very helpful. I will not be removing the stumps now, especially up by my house. Alright, so let's head up here to Sambor. That'll be one quest that we might be able to at least finish, so that will continue our chapter here. So let's head out there and see what we can do for that, and might get one step closer to finishing the quest. Alright, it says we're getting close to Sambor's place here. Oh, yep, I think I see it. We have arrived. You got a house and a hunting shack out here, I see. Think you're lost, boy. Sorry, I didn't mean to dist, whatever that means. Wait a second, look me in the eye and stop shivering for crying out loud, huh? Black and blue, you're Jordan's family, aren't you? Yes, my name's Rasimir. You must be Sambor, then. And how do you know that? I was talking to Unigost. He told me that you were a part of the Reminders as well. Part of what now? The Pack? The one with Unigost and Jordan? Never heard of this idiotic name in my life. Oh, sorry, maybe I've made a mistake. We were called the Undying Fist. Oh, that's so much worse, is my option. Or now that's a whole lot better name. Okay, well, we'll go with that. You're damn right it is. That's because I came up with it. Everyone loved it. No idea why Unigost lied to you like that. I'm sure he was just jealous about your creativity. Of course he was. And not only about that. Anyway, I'd love to hear some stories about my uncle and the Pack's adventures. I would love to spend my time telling you the old tales by the crackling fire. Oh my, really? No, leave my property and forget where it is. Oh, come on, it'll only take a moment. A moment of a moment, really. Just tell me what my uncle was like. How did he become a part of the Undying Fist? And how did you exactly... What did you do exactly as the Pack? You don't know what we did? Unigost didn't get to that part yet. This is a lot of dialogue, not gonna lie. This is not gonna be the channel for storytelling, I don't think. Because I definitely do not want to read all this dialogue. Alright. Well, there, we got that one. Quest updated. Dig up clay deposits. Well, I do know where there is... Oh... Is this a clay deposit right here? Because that would... Oh, this is. This is great. We're going to need this for insulating our house at some point, so... There we go. That's good to know there's clay deposits out here. Kind of a ways to go, but... Deliver to Sambor. I got you some clay, even though it was right outside your doorstep. I could have made you a shovel. You could have handled this on your own, buddy. Yeah, we're not reading all this dialogue. Wow. This is a whole video right there with just the dialogue. Okay. Deliver the knuckle sandwich to Unigost. Alright. Well, now we're heading back to town, I guess. Gotta love a quest that has you dig clay that's right outside the guy's doorstep when he could have easily just done it himself. Maybe there's more to that in the story if I had actually read all that dialogue, but that's okay. Not gonna lie, our town looks pretty nice down there. It's growing. We're gonna go all the way across here and then probably have some fields up over here would be neat to look at. It's definitely going to be a lot bigger than I'm thinking, because I've already moved well beyond this point in my playthrough that I'm not recording, so definitely gonna be pretty big. But we could even come across the water and build over here a little bit too. Whatever looks good. Is this? Yep, this is us right here. Unigoss, hello. I've talked to Sambor. He's a real sweetheart, isn't he? The sweetest, like a jar of honey. Yeah. Oh, there's still a lot of dialogue. It's 20 minutes of reading right here. All right.
Welcome.
Well,
it was
that.
Nice seeing you.
Okay, where's Ida? Well, it must be across the water. 200 meters away. Oh, we did complete some of the story. Yeah, we'll go do this. This isn't very far away. It's just up at the other town. Alright, so we are here. Where's Ida? There she is. She won it fair and square, she said. Hey, hit me with the riddle. First one, what disappears the second you say its name? Silence. Correct. Ready for the next one. Here it is. Feed me and I live, yet give me a drink and I die. What am I? A fire. Yeah, makes sense. Oh, you're good. Better than Mr. Big Castellan already, but can you get this final one? Listen carefully. I can fly, but have no wings. I can cry, but I have no eyes. Wherever I go, darkness follows me. What am I? I can fly, but have no wings. I can cry, but have no eyes. Wherever I go, darkness follows me. What am I? A cloud. Yeah. It's gotta be a cloud. Damn, you're sharp. Congratulations. You win the old man's crappy whatever, however you say that. Sickle? Is that what it is? Something like that. I think the same idea as a sickle. Doesn't get better than that. Thank you for the game. I had fun. Take care. More dynasty reputation, that's what we're after, because then we can build better buildings, or more buildings. Alright, let's take him his tool here. Those riddles weren't that difficult. I was a little bit worried about them, but... Alright, there's Unigoss going over here to sit down. Hey, buddy. Are there any troubles on the way? Not at all. Good news, Sambar is looking for you. For me? Are you sure? Yes.
Welcome.
It was nice. Did he not want his thing? Alright. Oh, we can make 10 buildings now. That's what we needed. Now we can get the... Oh, we did move on with that, too. chapters. Gotta hunt boar and fox, which will be easier once we get the bow. Dang it, we should have checked while we were over there at the other town to see if they had a linen thread, and then we could make a bow. That's okay, let's head back. We can get our wood shop going. I think that's the name of it. Then we can start getting some planks made and really start bumping up the money that we can make. So let's head back, get stuff done. Alright, I'm gonna grab a drink out of our well here. Alright, the wood shop should probably be someplace fairly close to this. Extraction, woodshed, here we go. I think we're gonna put it like right here. Let's do it. Alright, I think we're gonna need some stone. I think we have some somewhere. Maybe not, because we were making a bunch of knives. No, we do not. Well, looks like we have to go collecting. I think that's going to do it for this episode. We did kind of make some good progress here on this one. Get a lot of stuff done. We still have crops planting. This is the last day of summer. And then we move on to autumn. We do have a stone right here. So yeah, I'm going to finish building our workshop, and then when we come back next episode, we'll have the ability to really start making some money. And then once we get some food going, then we'll be able to have some workers here doing some tasks for us. One of them is just collecting logs so we can actually use those out and about for different projects. Logs are going to be used in everything that we craft, so it's not going to be a bad thing to have. We'll make a little road going out to here. Just like that. So our town is coming along. We're really going to boost our money-making opportunities with this workshop or woodshed now. So thank you guys so much for watching APN Gaming. We will see you guys next time for episode 6 of Medieval Dynasty. If you're liking this series, please leave a like down below, subscribe, hit that notification bell to stay up to date on all the newest content. We will see you guys next time.